Because, I mean, every generation, you know, naturally thinks their music's the best, because that's when the music you first dance to or kiss to, so it locks in your mind, is the best, you know. But every generation has revolutionary music, then it becomes status quo and then tacky, like Elvis or the Beatles, if they just stuck together, you know. Right, the Sex Pistols, I mean, punk music was, right, you know, remember 78, 79, I was like, whoa, radical punk music, you know. The Sex Pistols, all that, you know. It never became popular, but it was never going to become popular. Right, I mean, it was the title, you know, I mean, any of the songs, I mean, they have no future, they have no future. You see some 40-year-old guy, like, working, like, 80 hours a week to make mortgage payments, going, y'all want to hear more of this music, thank you very much, yeah. It was meant for like 15 and 16 year old hormonally rage. You know, yeah, there's no good. You know. But if the Sex Pistols got back together again, the three that are still living, you know, they like play Vegas. You know. Sure, they would. They play Vegas. Their fans be too old to slam dance, just kind of nudging each other like that, you know. God save the Queen. Ow! Don't hit so hard. I mean, I like the music that I grew up with, but I'm not thinking that that's the best music ever. I don't like it when people of my generation, I'm just talking about my generation. When you start talking about, oh, our music was the best. Music today doesn't say anything. Our lyrics meant something. It was important music. Things were going on and it said something. Come on, man. You know, that music could be as silly as any music ever. I mean, look at any, even the big groups like the Beatles. Beatles could be as silly as any group. Go back and listen to some of that music again. Like I Am the Walrus from the Magical Mystery Tour. Go listen to those lyrics again. See how they run like pigs from a gun. See how they fly. I'm crying. Sitting on a cornflake. I'd love to have been in John Lennon's mind when he wrote that song.
Oh, I'm sitting on a cornflake. Oh. Yoko, come in. I'm sitting on a cornflake. Pull up a raisin.
You know, I wasn't there, but you got at least be doing active fed to come up with a line like that. That's what I'm saying. It's so wild. I mean, it's just natural, you know. The music that the kids love the most is whatever the parents hate. That's the way it's always been. That's the way it always will. But they never learn. Even today, like, parents are trying to, like, control the volume and rap and heavy metal concerts, control labels and lyrics and the restrictions. And it's ridiculous. Parents never learn. If the parents ever jumped on board, the kids would dive over the set. Imagine a breakfast scene. Hey, Mom and Dad, we're going to go see Metallica tonight.
Why, we know, son. Your mother and I have seats right next to yours. We already have our T-shirts.
Metallica sales.